So in Shakespeare's play The Tempest, there's a scene where on this magic island, Caliban talks about how the air is full of noises, sounds and strange airs that are all billowing about his ears like a thousand twanging instruments. And it seems to me that with modern communications technology, this becomes true. It's not some fantasy. What telecommunications technology does is kind of reify, make real, put into the air itself what was previously only psychic. It turns the air into a psychic space. So schizophrenics might hear voices in the air around them, but with radio, it's true, there are voices. And I think there's an incredible poetry to that. To that situation, that all around us, messages are kind of billowing, fragments of important to someone else, important conversations, and in the early 20th century, many, mainly young boys, would spend night after night with their own little clobbered together radio receiving stations that they'd made from stolen bits of telephones and bits of wire and soup cans and so on. Just tuning in to these messages. And in a way also it's a kind of interesting model of what the artist might be, you know, instead of the person who originates the message, someone who kind of tunes in and picks up and remixes stuff, other messages that are already out there. So in this passage, Serge, the hero, has set up what must be one of the world's first experimental wireless stations, and he's trawling through the ether. Serge moves up to 500 meters. Here are stronger, more decisive signals. Coastal stations' call signs flung from towering masts. Poldhu is transmitting its weather report. A few nudges away, Malin, Cleethorpes, Nordyke send out theirs. Liverpool's exchanging messages with tugboats in the Mersey. Serge transcribes a rota of towing duties for tomorrow. Further out, the lightship tongues reporting a derelict's position. The coordinates click their way in to the C4th station, then flash out again to be acknowledged by Marconi operators of commercial liners, one after the other. The ship's names reel off in litany: Falaba, British Sun, Scania, Morea, Carmania. Each name appendaged by its church: Cunard Line, Allan, Aberdeen Direct, Canadian Pacific Railway, England, America.